been a little while since I've repaired anything on my channel, so it's time I put that right. I've spent most of this recent few weeks building storage for everything and making this nice worktop here. And the plan is to have some computers set up and consoles set up over on this side of the room that I can just use when I want to. It's something I haven't had before because there's not a lot of space when you've got 37 boxes piled up behind you, and it's not really an easy thing to keep them all out. But I've got that luxury now. But this screen has got a fault. Let me show you. Okay, if you look down here where the power light is, if I press the power button, nothing happens. The screen kind of flickers for a second, but nothing happens. And then eventually it will actually switch on. It might have actually gone a bit worse than it was before. So this is fairly typically bad capacitors, so let's fix that. This hasn't got a huge amount of screws, but it has got some horrible clips around the edges. Gone. So there's a couple of 1,000 nanofarads and a couple of 820, sorry, microfarads and a couple of 820 microfarad caps here. These are the ones that go. There's a video I'll link on YouTube where somebody's already, I followed their video, and they replaced these four and it came back to life. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. Usual warnings apply. The big old capacitor there, I think it's a 450 volt capacitor, that could give you a nasty shock. I will discharge that with a big resistor of some description, but I'm not going to show you that. I will do that off camera. Right, test. I've just discharged that capacitor and put my multimeter on it. 76 millivolts. I'm not even sure, it's probably got a discharge resistor on it somewhere, so I'm not even sure it actually had any charge in it. But let's get this disconnected and take this board out and get these caps changed and see if we can bring this thing back to life. Got some connectors here that need to go in back in the right way around, so I've just taken a picture to remind myself. Okay, to the workbench. First thing I'm going to do is with my new soldering iron, I'm going to add some leaded solder to the legs of the ones that I'm going to remove, which I've marked with dots. I better warm up my desoldering station as well, which I've set to 380 degrees because this is quite a heavy ground plane. This is taking a little while to melt these joints. My soldering iron's set to 350 degrees, so I could probably go higher, but I don't need to. I'm not desoldering these, I'm just adding some solder, so I'm just going to leave it at that for the moment. Nice big blobs. Yeah, they're melting much quicker now that I've got the leaded solder on there. It's just nicer. This might need two passes on some of these.
I'm pretty bored. Sorry, idea.
I think my desoldering station gun might need emptying. Goggles on.
Well, they're not too bad. Some of them look like they're mostly clear. They're not huge holes.
I'm going to just try and snip away off of this one. Yeah, that one's come out. That one's loose. Yep, that one's out. It's just this stuff on the board that's holding it. That one's loose as well. Oh, the soldering gun did a much better job than I actually thought it did. Now that one's coming out. That one's loose as well. That one's just covered in goop. That's an 820. So I'm just going to put a dot on the 820s to remind me. Single-sided board, so of course they desoldered nicely. Make sure that's 1,000. It is. I've got some 105 degrees. What were these rated? These were 105 degrees. Yeah. So they might not be anywhere. But they'll be newer. Be quite as fast as my pine saw to heat up, but this is a much more comfortable soldering iron to use. And it's going to take me a little while to get used to it because I used that pine saw or those pine saws for a number of years, the number being 2. Slightly different footprint. Thank you. It's always a good idea to check the capacitors that you take out just to make sure that they are the thing that's wrong. And so I'm gonna use my component tester here, which isn't the best thing for testing capacitors, but it does give us a rough idea. And I've actually, just so that we've got a baseline, this is one of the 1000 microfarad 10 volt caps, which would be the same as these W01s, 1000 10 volt, so that we can see where we're starting from and make sure that the tester is working. So 930.2 microfarads, V loss of 2.7% and ESR of 0.47 ohms. Is that good? These seem to be, I think these are Nishikon, or this one's a Nishikon, or it was advertised as such. So that's the 1000. Let's put in one of the other 1000s and give it a test. And taking its time. It's still testing. Okay, it thinks it's a ceramic capacitor of 32 picofarad. It's got no ESR or V loss on there. So yeah, that's probably the equivalent if I just connect my leads together. I wonder if that does the same thing. It's probably just gonna give us a resistance test. Yeah, it's a resistor, 33 ohms, or 0.33 ohms. Okay, so that's that one is broken. What about this one? This is the other 1000 microfarad cap. Yeah, this is taking a long time as well. Picofarad cap. They're both basically baked dry. What about these 820s? 820 microfarad and 25 volts. I have got a newer version of it here. 820, 25 volts. Let's see what this does. 167 microfarad, a V loss of 22% and 3.9 ohms. 22%. Okay, let's try the other one. I'm going to say that's out of spec, that one. It's missing some farads. 113. 28% V loss and 4.6 ESR equivalent series resistance. Yeah, these are broken. Let's just, for completeness, test the one of the ones that I've put in. So that's an 820 25 volt, 782.5 microfarad, 1.1% V loss and an ESR of 0.34 ohms. So there we go. Those are the broken caps. I will throw those in the bin where they belong. Now, should we see if it works? Okay, so the pink one's on the left. Like so. Board up. I'm not going to put the back panel on yet because there's some dirt in on the top of the speakers I want to clean out, but I just want to test it to see if it works. So let's just turn it over. Like that. Does it come on? Yeah, green light. glorious. Well, that was just a little quick one, but I hope you enjoyed it. And I will certainly enjoy this panel because it's got all of the inputs you could ever want, apart from HDMI, but then it's got DVI as well, which is easy enough to convert with a little adapter. So yeah, this is gonna serve me well. I'll see you in the next one, bye.
I don't know what buttons are. Ha 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 ha.